It's not the Republicans' fault that Joe Biden tagged her with this to some degree in 2020. I mean, it was Joe Biden who laid out the criteria for choosing a vice president, and his two principal criteria were
race. Wait, I'm sorry. Gender. You're saying that Joe Biden is made a DEI pick?
I'm saying that he unfairly, because she's qualified, tagged her with that in the first place. And that's not the Republicans' fault that Biden did that to her.
I don't know who that dude is, but he's not wrong. And I think it's hysterical that the CNN anchor was like, I'm sorry, what? Yeah, you heard me right. Clean the bleach out of your ears. You heard me correctly. It was Joe Biden that did it. He was the person who made this up. He was the guy who started this whole thing. And I disagree that, well, it's unfair because she's qualified. Says who? Qualified how? Not everyone who's qualified, not everyone seeking the office is qualified. I hate this. Well, because they're seeking office by nature of that, that means they're qualified. That's what that take requires. Welcome back to the program. Dana Loesch with you at the bottom of the second hour. No, I don't think that she's not qualified. She's just, no, she's not qualified. And it was Joe Biden that did this, which is why I think it's funny that they're trying to distract that with this, like, JD Vance. We played it last segment for headlines, where he was, you know, kind of joking that she's, you know, just this cat lady. And then you had Jennifer Aniston come out. Oh my gosh. And this chick will not miss a second to make something about her, apparently. She comes out and she says she was upset. Well, should we play his remarks again real quick so you guys know what we're talking about? Because they're going to try to make this a big deal. They're already trying it. Go ahead and play it. Yeah, play it. This was, just so you know, this audio resurfaced now. It was back when he was running for Senate. That's how. So now all of a sudden they're acting like it's a big deal. Listen to this.
Saying is that we're effectively run in this country via the Democrats, via our corporate oligarchs, by a bunch of childless cat ladies who are miserable at their own lives and the choices that they've made. And so they want to make the rest of the country miserable, too. And it's just a basic fact. You look at Kamala Harris, Pete Buttigieg, AOC, the entire future of the Democrats is controlled by people without children. And how does it make any sense that we've turned our country over to people who don't really have a direct stake in it?
He's not talking about the act of having, of giving birth. He's talking about just you have no children, period. And I don't know if Jennifer Aniston was smart enough to deduce that from his remarks that she's reacting to 2 years later, but because she apparently acts like she doesn't understand what he said. She wrote, on social media, she wrote that, quote, I truly can't believe that this is coming from a potential VP of the United States. All I can say is, Mr. Vance, I pray your daughter is fortunate enough to bear children of her own one day. I hope she'll not need to turn to IVF as a second option because you're trying to take that away from her, too, end quote. Well, Trump actually has said he's not against IVF, so I don't know what she's talking about, number one. So that desperate attempt to try to make this an attack on that as a way to separate, you know, some of the tent on the right is that's not a part of his platform. And Trump, as like I said, has already said he's in favor of it. So what are you arguing about? What is your problem? It sounds like you saw something that hit a little close to home and you're taking it personally. And why is this about you? I mean, what a way to just advertise your own neurosis there. No one thought of you as that, and then you just volunteer it. That's so weird, right? This was, again, when he was running for Senate, and it was, you know, it's pretty just wild that, you know, she's saying this now. Like, now, so she was on her Instagram stories, and that's what she was saying. That's where she made her remarks at. I can't believe. Well, he was not talking about IVF, and he's not talking about how you have kids. He's talking about people like you who apparently don't have any kids and want to tell everyone else how to raise their kids and raise their lives and all that stuff. I mean, okay, so I guess it did hit a little close to home for her. And is she upset about that? That's not all the rest of our problems. But it's just weird that, and of course she quoted the engagement farmer that the left uses for this kind of stuff. And I don't know, again, why she brought up IVF, because Trump has said that he's in favor of IVF. So I don't know why she brought that up as a way to say that Vance was trying to take that from her, too. That doesn't make any sense. Kane, what is your thought?
My thought is it's intentional, because the narrative that they're building is that the right is so against all these freedoms. So they don't care if it's true or not. They don't care if there's any honesty behind that statement. They only care to create that narrative as we roll into November.
Yeah, That's what it seems like. But how lame is that? I mean, if you're trying to dispel the notion that you yourself are an angry cat lady, then why would you act like one? I mean, clearly he's kind of, you know, making a joke, but I don't know. Is that is part of, you know, being an angry cat lady, taking everything quite literally as well? I don't know. He's free to make it. And I think he's completely fine with in saying this. And this has nothing to do with, for those who lack the listening comprehension, this has nothing to do with IVF. And he wasn't talking about actually giving birth to your own children, because other people after Jennifer Aniston said that were trying to make it about adoption, et cetera. It's just so stupid. According to a March 2024 report from the Association of American Medical Colleges, the U.S. is facing a shortage of 86,000 doctors by 2036. Already, wait times to see a doctor nearly reach 4 weeks. That's a troubling trend set to worsen. And your alternative? Lengthy hours in the ER or urgent care amid a whole crowd of ill people. Yeah, no. Mm-mm. Take control of your own health care. Order a medical emergency kit from the Wellness Company. Now, this is not, I repeat, it's not a first aid kit. It's like having an urgent care in your home. It's super handy. It comes with doctor-prescribed medicines for over 30 medical issues, antibiotics for infections, strep throat, I've used it, pneumonia, bronchitis, all kinds of stuff. Match your symptoms to the prescription in your booklet and take the correct meds now to get well faster. There's no waiting for a doctor or a pharmacy or being around tons of sick people. Every home should have at least one medical emergency kit, and you can order yours online in literally minutes. Get 15% off at twc.health/Dana and use promo code Dana. That's promo code Dana at twc.health/Dana. So this is the way the left is. Like for instance, over at Newsweek right now, have you guys seen this headline? I can't even deal with this. Donald Trump may not have been hit by a bullet after all, says the FBI director. That was one of the things that he mentioned or that he had said. Oh, my gosh. Did you see the literal, like, shredded ear photo? I don't think we should show it because it is kind of gross, if I'm being real. There's a photo, and there are three different photographers from three different photo services at three different angles that have a photo of his ear, and it's literally torn in half, and it's bleeding. It's real nasty. All of them are nasty looking, so I don't know if we really want to show that, but it's out there if you want to go see it, but it's pretty gory looking. I mean, because his ear was shot. I mean, that's how close he came, and it is weird that that was something that Ray, who's such a jackass, even floated. And because Jim Jordan had asked Ray if all of the 8 bullets that this guy fired were accounted for. And he said, well, we know that he lost his life and 2 other rally goers were injured and that one hit the president. And that's what Jordan was asking. And he goes, well, where did all 8 bullets go? And when what Ray said was, quote, as I said, I think with respect to former President Trump, there's some question about whether or not it's a bullet or shrapnel that hit his ear. And it is wild. It is wild to me that he is saying, and I mean, you can see his ear. I don't want to show this picture because it's gross.
Oh, because Juan has.
Do we?
Okay,
go ahead.
I mean,
guys,
this is
I'm warning you, it's gross. Okay. And there's also a photo as well that is, it shows the, I was trying to remember who took it. It was like a Getty photo, I think. That shows a bullet that is going right towards him. And you can see it. You know, it's a round going right towards him. I don't know. This is weird. I mean, you can see, like, he's missing part of his ear. I mean, it's weird. And then he's got, and Lorraine noted, she's got a picture of his, of the a Band-Aid that came undone on his ear. And you can literally see a portion of his ear is off. So that's how close that came. When I look at it even more, I'm like, that's wild.
Yeah. They have zoomed in video of the moment that his ear was penetrated by the bullet. You'll actually see it happen. And it's actually pretty astounding. I know Juan's about to put up the picture of the actual frame of the video that actually captures the bullet in mid-flight. And I got to tell you, this is a... I mean, the fact
that's the photo right there.
Yeah, there it is right there. The fact that they're trying to create
shrapnel,
this narrative that it wasn't a bullet, or that there was, you know, they're trying to downplay the Trump thing while the whole time they were trying to, you know, exaggerate Biden's abilities.
I mean, they already had the Secret Service spokesperson confirm that it was a bullet and not shrapnel. And they even had Snopes. I can't even believe I'm saying this. Snopes, you know, the very super conservative website, Snopes. Yeah. I mean, it's about as conservative as you can get with Snopes. Even saying, no, it was literally a bullet. There's photographic evidence. There's video of it. I mean, there's, what else do you need? I mean, this is just a stupid political way to try to diminish what took place here, because it's a, it's powerful, and they're trying to diminish it. They're trying to diminish this, the influence of this. I just, the fact that Ray said that, even, and he said that after the, after Secret Service had already confirmed it, after Snopes, after you had forensics that was looking at the photographic evidence, even looking at his ear, etc. I mean, come on, guys. That was just Ray being a partisan. That's all that was. He was just being a partisan there. It's ridiculous. Now, a few other things, too, to touch on. And by the way, the thing with the Vance thing, I want people to understand this. The situation with Vance and then them reacting to that soundbite 2 years ago from him and Jennifer Aniston. I mean, I don't... I got stuff in my own life. Like, I got a new puppy, a rescue pup that we're dealing with right now, and I don't got time to sit here and boss everybody around on their own lives. The point of this is that they're trying to make bring this around to abortion and IVF. Well, they're trying to bring it around to IVF and through that abortion. That's the whole play you need to recognize with that. That's what they're trying to do with that audio soundbite, and that's why they brought Aniston onto it. That's why they're trying to do this right now. They're trying to blow that up to eventually make that another way, another front in this, their battle with abortion. That's what they're trying to do with it. So I think people need to not take it personally and realize it for the hit job that they're trying to make it, because that's the whole point of it. That is the whole point of it. And this, and again, 2 years, and the fact that it's just too convenient. It came through their engagement farmer, that the guy that we know worked with the campaign to put out sound bites, and he tries to act like he's just the citizen who writes on Substack. Oh, come on. I can't. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.